Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, we're going to use coordinate notation to describe the rotations about the origin that we worked with in our previous lesson. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to use coordinate notation to describe rotations 90 degrees, 180 degrees, and 270 degrees about the origin. First, we'll learn how to write coordinate notation for the three examples from our previous rotation lesson. And then we'll complete two additional examples similar to what you'll see in your practice. Here's the first problem from our performing rotations lesson. We had rotated the pre-image 90 degrees about the origin. And here are our new directions. Now we're supposed to find the coordinate notation to describe what happened to the points when they were rotated 90 degrees counterclockwise, or 270 degrees clockwise, about the origin. We can start by writing the general notation that we always use. Then we have to look for a pattern like we did in our other coordinate notation lessons. There is a pattern when going from the pre-image to the image, but it's tougher to find than it was in the other lessons. Take some time here to pause the video and try to find the pattern yourself. Remember, we're looking for how the X and Y coordinates changed between the pre-image and the image. So look for changes between these coordinates like a number in a different spot or a different sign paired with each number. Let's see if you were able to figure this out. The X values from the pre-image moved to become the second coordinate in the image. We can show that in our notation by writing X in the location where Y normally goes. We can also see that the original Y values moved to become the first coordinate in the images, but also changed signs. We can show this in our coordinate notation by writing negative y. And we have our final answer. Here's the notation we were looking for. Remember, this notation applies to a 90 degree counterclockwise rotation and a 270 degree clockwise rotation. Here's the second problem from our previous lesson. And here are our new directions. This time we have to find the coordinate notation for a 180 degree rotation about the origin, either clockwise or counterclockwise, since those would both take us to the same place. Let's start by writing the general notation we always use. Then let's look for the pattern like we always do. This pattern might be kind of tough to find too, so pause the video here and give yourself some time to try it. Let's check it out together. The X values from the pre-image stayed in the first coordinate of the image, but changed signs. We can show that in our notation by writing negative X as the first value of the image coordinate. We can also see that the original Y value stayed as the second coordinate in the images, but also changed signs. We can show this in our coordinate notation by just writing negative Y. And that's our final answer. This is the final problem from the previous lesson. And here are our new directions. This time we're working with either a 270 degree counterclockwise or a 90 degree clockwise rotation. So pause the video now and try this problem all by yourself. Let's check your work. We can start with the general notation and then look for a pattern. This time, the X values from the pre-image moved to become the second coordinate in the image and changed signs. We can write that as negative X being the second coordinate of the image. We can also see that the original Y values became the first coordinate in the image. To show this, we just write Y as the first coordinate. And again, we have our final answer. On the next slide, we're going to move on to a few more questions that are similar to what will be asked on the practice for this lesson. But before we do that, make sure you're all caught up on your notes. This problem says, Given the pre-image, F, and the coordinate notation of the transformation, write the coordinates of the image, F prime. What type of transformation is occurring? Pause the video now and think through this yourself. Our coordinate notation tells us that X stays in the same position but changes sign. Our original X value is -4, so changing signs on that gives us +4 as the X value of our image. Then we go back to our notation and see that the Y value changes signs as well. Our original Y value is 2, so we change the sign and write -2. Then we have to think back to all the coordinate notation rules that we just developed and figure out which rule said that the image is -x, -y. We just saw this notation in the second example today, so we know that this represents a rotation 180 degrees, either counterclockwise or clockwise. Now, we have both parts of our answer. Here's the final example. It says, given the image, point H prime, and the coordinate notation of the transformation, write the coordinates of the pre-image, point H. So since we're given the image, we're gonna have to work backwards to find the pre-image. Pause the video now and see what you can come up with. Our coordinate notation tells us that negative X is -3. We can write that as an equation and solve for X by dividing or multiplying by -1. We place the value we found for X in the beginning of our pre-image coordinate. We can also see that Y is equal to -6. We don't really have to set up an equation for this because we already have Y. We just have to write -6 as the Y coordinate in our pre-image. Remember to set up equations and solve anytime you need to be able to visualize how to get back to the pre-image. Sometimes you may want to skip writing an equation and solving it, but errors can occur more easily if we do that. Anyways, we have our answer. Now you can use coordinate notation to describe rotations about the origin. Also, I want to remind you that there is a summarizing rotations activity in your notes template that would be best to complete before doing the practice for this lesson. Anyways, we'll see you later, Mia. And I'll see you next time. Hey.